ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، ونشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف بإذن ربه الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله الشرفاء وصحبه النجباء وعلى من دعا بدعوته وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده وسار على منهجه واقتفى أثره بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في التنزيل العزيز: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم. Can everyone participate please? كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Respected scholars, respected elders, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before I start, I have to announce at least three things. Number one, for the first time in the last 10-15 years, there will be food after Sirat Mahfil here in Darul Uloom. And I think that because of the honor of our beloved young Sheikh Qadi Lutfur Rahman. Okay, don't think that will be happening every year. It may not happen every year, but it's happening exceptionally for this year. Barakallah. Barakallah. That's what my second I asked. That's why we need to, Sheikh, you need to come every month. Then we'll have food, inshallah, every month. Barakallah. That's announcement number one. Number two, Sheikh Lutfur Rahman, he is representing East London in the Central Mosque of West London. And it's not easy to get in West London from East London. It's extremely, extremely difficult. And you know, the West London controlling the whole UK. And the Regent's Park Central Masjid is there. That's why, thank you very much. Keep representing us there, inshallah. And maybe he's the British Bangladeshi first Imam there. It's not easy, you know, there, you know, the constitution is if the director is Saudi, Imam has to be Masri, Egyptian. Is there, you know, the constitution like that? I know about that. And exceptionally, mashallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted him, and we make dua for him that he stay there for longer, inshallah. Do a better job. And go, inshallah, up and up and up, inshallah. And these young brothers, you know that this family, I especially make dua for their dad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. May Allah ta'ala make his grave rather to men riyadun. Qadi Abdurrahman, Qadi, then Arif Hafiz Abdul Subhan Shaman, Namun Yasa Ustad, I'm going to Then Qadi Lutfur Rahman, Qadi Ashikur Rahman, and Sahibullah Maska Sunni, Femnasya Shafiqur Rahman, mashallah. They're very good brothers, very good family. May Allah bless them.
Amen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them from the all the, you know, the this jealousy other people have towards them, inshallah.
Amen.
And keep doing the dawah of Islam, inshallah. May Allah accept it. That was number two. And number three, a brother came to me and said that, Sheikh, afni kintu Bangla koiba, what is Bangla sir? Then I have seen lots of young brothers sitting here. And it's extremely, extremely difficult to do the justice now. That's why what I'll be doing, I have to be Banglish, I'll be talking a bit of English and a bit of Bangla, inshallah. But what I want to see, people are not going away because food is waiting for you, at least. If you're not waiting for me, wait for food, please. When I'm talking Bangla, young people, I want to see how much Bangla you know. Try to understand, because I speak very easy Bangla. Even I speak Sylheti Bangla as well, alhamdulillah. Even some people believe that, you know, that I am from the Sylhet already. Either from Hobigonj or from Sunamgonj. That's always people would say that, alhamdulillah. Because sometimes I know more Sylheti language than you do, because you know only your area, but I know all the areas, alhamdulillah. That's why when I'm speaking, you know, the Bangla, young people, be patient with that, inshallah. And English, when I'm speaking English, then everybody is London, you know, and everybody understand English. When you go to the, you know, the council office, going to the shop, going here and your friend, you're talking English. Even our sisters, doesn't matter, broken English, but our Bengali is broken Bengali. Is it broken Bengali is allowed, why not broken English is allowed? That's why it's okay. And anybody, you know, that my dad doesn't speak English. Do you speak Bengali? Come on, man. Speak Bangla, then you're like your dad. Then on other occasion, we remember that. When the Sultan's son's Aqiqa, I said that, you know, that everybody hate freshy, but everybody love fresh things. Why that's happening? You know that you're going to the fish market, Mas Bazar, fresh fish. Then you're, you know, they're telling somebody, you know, saying you're freshy, but you're a son of a freshy then. That's the only difference. That's the language doesn't matter. What I have seen in many, many programs, even people don't understand, still they are sitting down. Why they are sitting down? Because they know that the sitting has a barakah. And you say, glad tiding I want to start with. That time you'll be sitting here, my brother, my sister, if you're sitting with the full sincerity, before you get out from the masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be forgiving your sins. It's now, it's today, if you have the sincerity. That's the glad tiding. And the final one, please, if you are recording while you're going live, then keep your mobile with you. Otherwise, your mobile will take you out very soon. That's why, just if you're not using it, put it. I put my one away, it's on recording, I put it away already. If you are doing live or recording, keep it with you. Otherwise, your phone should not be disturbing you. And this sitting, this majlis will be beneficial for all of us, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it, say ameen. And you know the topic. The topic is da'wah in the life of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Amader asker bishoy holo Allah Rasulir jibone da'wah. Can you tell me what is the topic I will be discussing, young man? Da'wah in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is it?
Da'wah.
Da'wah. Da'wah. Okay, anybody, if you are, you know, the about younger than 15, you're not 15, 15 or less, I have a question to you. Can somebody tell me, what does da'wah mean? What is it? What is da'wah? Da'watul Islam has a center, Darul Ummah. Da'watul Islam has Jamiatul Ummah. Brother Hassan Muinuddin is the Amir of Da'watul Islam. Brother Shabir is the Secretary General. What does da'wah, what da'wah mean? Anybody 15 or younger? What does da'wah mean? Don't be shy. It's an open question for young people. Let me see the young people are following or they're busy with something else. Even people sitting at the back. Can somebody tell me very quickly? What does da'wah mean? No one, subhanAllah. Yes. I know the answer will be coming very soon. Yes, go ahead. Or inviting people to food. Well done. MashaAllah. What he said, da'wah means inviting people to Islam. Normally in our tradition, da'wah, you know, the da'wah of food. We've been invited to eat somewhere. That's also include da'wah. If inviting people for food, no problem with that. But da'wah in Islam means that inviting people to Islam. Okay. তাহলে দাওয়াত বোঝা যায় যে মানুষদেরকে ইসলামের দিকে ডাকা, ইসলামের আহ্বান জানানো, এটা হলো দাওয়াত. Now we want to understand why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending prophets, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending all the books. Allah rabbul alamin nabi rasulদেরকে কেন পাঠালেন, কেন Allah rabbul alamin kitab দিলেন? Look, prophets are, you know, that is a relation, is a connection in between God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to speak to you and me here in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was not sending wahi to everyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to connect it with us. And Allah Ta'ala want that we are connected to Him. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala selecting some individuals to be the prophets, to be the messengers. Allahu yastafi min al malaikati rusulahu wa minan nas. Allah Ta'ala selects messengers from the angels and from the human being. Allah Rabbul Alameen, manushir muddho theke, ferishtadir muddho theke, erakom, rasul dirke, Allah Rabbul Alameen, tadirke select kore. Not every single angel came with the Quran. Not every single angel came with the revelation. Not every single angel came with the, you know, the, to any other prophet like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's only Jibreel. Then Allah Ta'ala selected Jibreel alayhi salam, and given him a specific responsibility that he will be coming to the messengers, to the prophet with the revelation, with wahi. That selection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa minan nas, and Allah ta'ala will be selecting certain individuals from the people, from a human being. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, he didn't know that. He will be the prophet, he will be the Nabi. He will be the messenger. If he know that, then he not going to be scared when Jibreel alayhi salam coming to him. When he's coming out from Ghar Hira, coming to Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha and telling her, لَقَدْ خَشِيتُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِي. Khadija, I became scared about my life. Maybe I'm not going to survive. Maybe I will die. If he knew that, he will be the prophet. Then he said, oh, good. I was waiting for it and it came today. I'm so happy. No, that's not the case. He didn't know that he will be selected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Jibreel alayhi salam coming out. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam walking in the street. And Jibreel alayhi salam addressing the prophet and saying, Ya Muhammad, Anta Rasulullah. Then he's looking up. And look who Jibreel is talking to him. Subhanallah. It's a direct connection, direct conversation with Jibreel alayhi salam. Even he becoming more scared, what's happening, what will happen. Then finally, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became familiar with it. And the wahi, the Quran, the revelation is so strong, so heavy,
Jibreel alayhi salam coming in the winter season, and sometime in Medina can be very, very cold. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam sweating. Why sweating? Because wahi coming. Inna sanulqi alayka qawlan thaqeel. Subhanallah. It's so heavy things coming to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then remember, prophets, they didn't know that before prophethood they will be the prophet. They had a different character. They used to be the good people in the community, but many of them didn't know that they will be the prophet. Shammanito bhai bonera ekta jinish khyal rakhben. Nobi ebong rasulra Allah rabbul alaminer pokkho theke hoy. Nije dabi korle nobi howa jay na. Gulam Ahmad naam hoilei nobi dabi korle nobi keu mane mane na. পয়সা দিয়েও মানানো যায় দেখেন, এই জন্য নবী যদি কেউ দাবি করে নবী হওয়া যায় না। নবী হতে হলে আল্লাহ তাআলার রহমত লাগে, আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিনের সিলেকশন লাগে, এবং মুহাম্মদুর রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লামকে আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিন সিলেকশন করেছেন। আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিন তাকে সর্বশেষ নবী, রহমাতুল্লিল আলামিন বানিয়েছেন। বলুন সুবহানাল্লাহ, সুবহানাল্লাহ। Then, the next important thing, what I want to tell everybody. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came as a da'i ilallah. He had lots of responsibility because he is the head imam of the masjid. He's the head of the state and he's a father. He's the head of the army. And Rasulullah is a good neighbor. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a businessman. Many responsibility Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had. But the one of the biggest responsibility Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had, he came to this world as da'i ilallah. Ya ayyuhan nabi, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira wa da'iyan ilallahi bi'idhnihi wa sirajan. Ayyuhan Nabi, O Prophet, inna arsalnaka, indeed I have sent you, shahidan, you will be the witnessing, you'll be the witness, wa mubashiran, giving the glad tidings, good news, always good news. Then your good news is you're sitting here patiently, Allah is forgiving your sins. That's the good news for you today. Don't forget that. If you want to get out, remember, if you go out, the sins not going to be forgiven. Sitting here, your sins will be forgiven, inshallah, biiznillah, because of your ikhlas, because of your sincerity. Mubashiran wa nadhira, warning people, be careful. Shaitan is there. Hellfire is waiting. Be careful. Always careful. Always drug dealers are around here. People want to, you know, they misguide you. Very, very careful. In the all the smartphone, smart, you know, the spoiling there. Shaitan is there. Your friend can be a big, big shaitan. Very, very careful. Careful always. My dear wife, you are sitting alone all the time on the phone. You will be addicted to the phone. My dear child, you are going to the school. Very, very careful. They want to do something to you. Don't lose out. Very, very careful. Giving warning to everybody. Then what? وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا, and the da'i, caller, calling, inviting, إِلَى اللَّهِ, towards Allah, بِإِذْنِهِ, with the permission of Allah, وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا, and the bright light. Allah Rabbul Alameen, Allah Nabi ke da'i ila Allah kure pathiye. আল্লাহ নবী সুসংবাদ দিয়ে বলবেন, ঈমান আনো, জান্নাতে চলে যাবে, মসজিদে বসে ওয়াজ শুনবে, ইখলাসের সাথে গুনাহ মাফ হয়ে যাবে। আল্লাহ নবীকে আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিন পাঠালেন মানুষদেরকে সাবধান করবে, তোমার ঘরেও কিন্তু নিজের ঘরে নিজের শত্রু, তোমার ছেলে শত্রু হয়ে যেতে পারে, মেয়ে শত্রু হতে পারে, হাজবেন্ড ওয়াইফ একজন আর একজনের এনিমি হয়ে যেতে পারে আল্লাহর পথে না থাকলে। মানুষ রূপী শয়তানের কোনো অভাব নাই দুনিয়াতে, ইবলিস তো আছেই, কাজেই কেয়ারফুল, নিজেকে ধ্বংস করো না। আর দাওয়াত দেওয়ার জন্য আল্লাহর রাসূল এসেছেন,
আল্লাহ রাসূল বলেন উজ্জ্বল আলোকবর্তিকা, বলেন সুবহানাল্লাহ।
Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to this dunya as a da'i ila Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I was thinking today, I was studying Ar-Rahiq al-Makhtub and seeing what happened, what Shaykh, that is the best seerah book available. I know I'll be telling that at the end, what to do and how we can be connected to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how we can connect our young children to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That will be the conclusion of da'wah inshaAllah, and how every single one of us can be the da'i ila Allah at home and abroad and the school and the masjid and everywhere, wherever you go, we have to be da'i ila Allah. That I'll be talking a bit later inshaAllah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he is coming, the year he was born, look like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making a big change. Abraha came to destroy the Kaaba, he couldn't do it. And nobody from the Meccan people, they're protecting Kaaba. When Abdul Muttalib was asked by Abraha that, Abdul Muttalib, we want to destroy your Kaaba, what he, do worship. Then Abdul Muttalib said, we don't worship Kaaba. If you want to destroy it, destroy it. Because I don't have my army that I can, fight with you. It's up to you. I don't have any opinion about that. Your, the army taking my camels, give my camels back and I'll go. Then Abraha was surprised. Then Abdul Muttalib said, Amma ana fa rabbul ibil wa inna lil bayti rabban yahmihi. Amma ana, I, Abdul Muttalib, Rabbul Ibil, I'm the owner of the camel. Give me my camel, I'll go back home. Wa inna lil bayti rabban yahmihi. And this house has a lord, has an owner. This house has an owner. Yahmihi, if he wants to protect it, he will protect it. If he allows you to destroy it, then he destroyed. I'm not the owner of the house. Owner of the house is Allah. If Allah wants to protect it, Allah will protect it. Then what happened? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not been born yet. Look, da'wah started already. Then Allah ta'ala is keeping this in seed and eternal until the day of Qiyamah. Allah Rabbul Alameen giving wahi saying, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْلِيلٍ وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلَ. Do you know what Allah Ta'ala did with the people of elephant? Does any young man know what happened to the people of elephant? What happened? Anybody younger? Yes, can you tell me a little bit? What happened there?
Allah set birds with stones in their feet and they dropped
the birds and the stone in their feet. What happened then?
The birds flew over the elephants and dropped the stones, and then the stones killed the elephants and the people.
The biggest stone or smallest stone? Oh, how come a small stone killing the big elephant? Surprising, isn't it? Well done, you're a good storyteller, mashallah. Well done, you did very well. People at the back, are you following? Do you know the story? Anyone there? You can tell a little bit, inshallah, very quickly, yeah. What happened then? Abraha wanted them to go towards Kaaba, and the elephant said no. Did the elephant speak at that time or just sitting down? Okay, then what happened? Very good, mashallah. I'm so happy. Even our young people know better than we do. Well done to you, mashallah. Very good. Batsara dekhen onek kichu jane ja amra jani na. Eta lojjar kichu na. Amar bachcha beshi janle to amar khushi. Thik na kotha? If my children know more than me, then I'm happy. Alhamdulillah. Sorry, bhai. Beshi bangla koile tara thakta na. Jai bhagi. Let's do the mix up. Thik ache ni? Apni khushi achen ni? Very good. One brother came specifically for Bengali. Okay, inshallah, let's mix it up better. Okay, then, what's happening now? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, did not come to this dunya yet. Da'wah started already. And Allah ta'ala doing the da'wah on behalf of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abraha is gone. And the big incident in the history of human civilization. Everybody remember that. than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So subhan, subhan. Allah nubi duniyate ashar age Allah rabbul alamin Abraha ke ek hi bosor matro 40 din age dhongsho kore dilo. Tale Allah rasuler daawat ta shuru hoye gelo Allah nubi ashar age jodi Kaaba ghor ke shedin bhenge fela hoto তাইলে কি এই কাবায় গিয়ে আমরা এখন হজমরা করতে পারতাম? সুবহান আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিন এই ঘরের মালিক, আল্লাহ এই ঘরকে হেফাজত করেছেন। বলুন সুবহানাল্লাহ। দেন আল্লাহর নবীর দাওয়াতটা আল্লাহর নবীর জন্মের আগ থেকে শুরু হয়েছে। দ্য রিয়েল দাওয়া স্টার্টেড বিফোর রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম ওয়াজ বর্ন ইভেন। লুক নাও হি ইজ বর্ন অ্যাজ অ্যান অরফান। ওকে, The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was born, there is no dad. Dad passed away before he was born. Now the orphan prophet, there are so many big people, prime ministers, they are the president, they are the rich people, and they are the follower of an orphan prophet. Subhanallah. If you think about that, then what's happening? Second element of da'wah, look, very young child, then taken away from mom, having a breastfeeding mom, Halimatu Sa'diya. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is having only one breast, not the other one. Halimatu Sa'diya, she's narrating that, my son Muhammad, I tried both of my breasts to, when breastfeeding him, to have milk from. But he's never ever having both. Because I had another son, Abdullah ibn al-Haris. And always Muhammad is keeping one breast for his brother. That was the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's tradition all the way of the time of the breastfeeding. Can you imagine? Say subhanallah. Ma Halimatu Sa'diya bornona koren je amar sele Muhammad tar shonge aro ekta sele to amar chilo. Historian bolen tar nam chilo Abdullah ibn al-Haris. Whatever it is, ami jehetu onno manusher bachcha anchi kaje ami chaichi dui ta dudhi khawai take. Kintu Allahr qasam kore boli jotodin amar dudh kheyeche kono ekta din dui ta dudh khay na, ekta kheyei take ar ekta mukhe dilo khay. Subhanallah. আর এই জন্যই তো রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম রাহমাতুল লিল আলামিন, ওয়া মা আরসালনাকা ইল্লা রাহমাতাল লিল আলামিন। বলুন সুবহানাল্লাহ। দেন রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম ইভেন দাঈ ইলা আল্লাহ ওয়েন হি ইজ এ ব্রেস্ট ফিডিং বেবি। সুবহানাল্লাহ। এন্ড ইট গোজ আহেড এন্ড গোজ আহেড এন্ড গোজ আহেড। Then in Bani Sa'd, normally the children, what they will be fighting. There will be something would happen among children. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not fight with anybody. Our young children here, ask them, some of them been in trouble in the playground. Because they're pushing other people. They're using the, the foul language, swearing word. Many of them may have problems. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not fight with anybody anytime. That what is da'wah? It's a young person, the young boy, he's growing up like that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam jatudin Bani Sa'd eriyate chilen. Apnara jara Bani Sa'd e giyechen, Arafar dik theke jodi apni Taif er dike jan, Hadar rasta diye, tahole rastar pashe kichu dur gele Bani Sa'd er eriya porbe. যদি কোনো সময় সুযোগ হয় দেখে আসবেন, রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম উস্তাদ ফারুক ইসামি এরিয়াতে বহুবার গেছেন, আমি নিজে অনেকবার গিয়েছি। আপনি গেলে ভালো লাগবে যে রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম বিন ব্রেস্টফিড হিয়া এন্ড হি ওয়াজ গ্রোয়িং আপ হিয়া ইন বানি সাদ। সুবহানাল্লাহ। দ্যাট ওয়াজ হিজ দাওয়া ওয়েন হি ইয়াং চাইল্ড। দেন রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম কামিং ব্যাক, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is really worried what's happening in Makkah. There is no justice. There's so much bad stuff happening. As many of our young people worried about London, so much bad stuff happening in London. So many things happening around us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was worried about Makkah. What's happening here? Even people cannot come and do the ziyarah of Kaaba. They cannot do the tawaf. People are coming, then they've been robbed. Then people are coming, then they've been killed. And so many bad stuff happening. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as part of his da'wah, he's starting Hilful Fudul. Hilful Fudul was an agreement like the society. In other, now we have so many society. This society, every single village, we have a society. Again, প্রত্যেক গ্রামের কিন্তু আমাদের সমিতি একটা আছে, ঠিক কিনা? এত সমিতি, what I have noticed, every single day in London, over 30 meeting going on, every day. Even weekend will be around over 50 meeting. And weekdays at least 30 meeting going on. Every single village we have a shomiti. We have an association. We have this shomiti, that shomiti, trust. And we are doing it, then we are fighting. Then that day they have election in the Luma, we need to call police. So many times that happened. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't do it. What Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did, that the people are coming to Makkah, we want to make them safe. They can come to Makkah, they can do the tawaf of Kaaba, they can do the sa'i, they can go back safely. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. আল্লাহ নবী চাইলেন মক্কা কাবা ঘরে এসে মানুষ তওয়াফ করতে পারে। আমরা মানুষ যাতে করে সহি সালামতে তওয়াফ করে, সাই করে, হজ উমরা করে চলে যেতে পারে, তাহার জন্য যুবকদেরকে নিয়ে রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম অর্গানাইজেশন বানালেন, জাস্ট ইউথ অর্গানাইজেশন, হোয়াট ইউ নেম ইট, দ্যাট ইজ ইওর ইয়ুথ গ্রুপ। দ্যাট রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম হ্যাড এ ইয়ুথ গ্রুপ এট দ্যাট টাইম, and he is working with the similar young people, and they are protecting people from any kind of problem they are facing, and the any kind of zulm they are facing, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam helping them, supporting them. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gradually became very, very worried now. Now there is no solution. This is small, the organization cannot do anything. Couldn't be able to make any difference. Now he is going away from the society.